So lock it.
Continue. It says Trump is under constant attack because he represents a serious threat to the globalist elite and their plans to create a new world order and merge our nations into the North American Union, rendering our Constitution and Bill of Rights null and void. Now, to a certain extent, it's truth to that, but at the same time, for you to not think that he's a part of it, I mean, Trump is looking like a welfare case as opposed to some of these, the real rich elite that he actually is doing the bidding of. Who you think's idea was for him to actually, like, just let the government shut down like that? Like, come on, he's a businessman. At the end of the day, I was just listening to the brothers going to, it was a few brothers went into how, you know, the store closes and whatnot, and how all these stores close. And the truth be told, the government being shut down that long actually helped to close a lot of these fucking stores. Because you just took out almost a million. That's not even the whole number. You had 800,000 furloughed. That means that people that just weren't even receiving pay. Then you had those that were still getting paid. I mean, Salaki, some those that were still working but not getting paid. So that's all money that was taken out of the economy that hurt this economy. You don't think this businessman that grew up in business all his fucking life didn't know what he was doing was going to affect his economy? Like, come on, man. That's what I say, like, I don't know. Like I said, some people blindly follow. But then, you know, like I said, some people is really just set up on the left-hand side like a imposter like Bill Hicks that call himself Alex Jones. How the fuck can you even respect or pay attention to what this guy said? You done changed your name. I could see if you had to change your name because you had a government hit on you or something like that, but you just changed your name. Why did you change your name? So how would anything you say is relevant to show you how, you know, stupid people are for real? Anyhow, in America, we have freedom of religion, speech, and press. And to a certain extent, that's true. That's where we can go and have our platforms and, you know, what's that in 1 Corinthians? And try and bid them to the marriage, you know. Or in the book of Luke 14, where it says, go out on the highways and byways. And, you know, that's what how we got our platform. So to a certain extent. But at the same time, they're trying to take back a lot of the freedoms that you had. That's why they're coming up to your guns. They're trying to censor what you can say. Shit, the brother from Kansas City just was talking about how they just passed a bill, which Trump did, about anti-Semitism. You know what I mean? So, you know, for his Khazarian masters. It says, we must diligently protect these rights, along with our economy, global influence, state-of-the-art technologies, creativity, a unique American can-do mindset. These assets are vital to fulfill the prophetic role Yahweh intended America to play in the last days, and that is to serve as a global platform for preaching the gospel. Damn! Now, that's spiritual, though, because at the end of the day, just like we believe that the internet was created for the truth, which it was, you know what I mean? Like, you get all that goofy shit on there, but what is really, I mean, like I said, we didn't have to actually go like how you got certain groups like IUIC and certain, they've got all this money that they can go to Israel or they can go to other countries, Africa, you know. We basically, you know, the way I found out about the truth was through the internet. I didn't meet the elders, apostles, or whatnot. Actually, I found out about other camps before I found out about the elders, to be honest. You know what I'm saying? But to show you how powerful the thing is, you know, it's like pay it forward, you know what I mean? They learn from elders, and now they keep it going. Like, it's a tradition. It's a beautiful thing when you take time to really think about it. But yeah, America is set up for that, but it's not set up in the way that he's trying to explain. Like, it's for this truth in the last days to push this truth, because this is going to be where the major, we're in captivity here. So, you know, just like how Egypt, ancient Egypt, because this is the modern day Egypt, you know, with it was the major exodus. It's gonna be an exodus from this place as well. It says, These usses are vital to fulfill the prophetic role Yahweh intended America to play in the last days, and that is to serve as a global platform, preaching the gospel, making disciples of all nations, and doing what Yahweh said in Luke 19 and 13, to occupy till I come. And that's by doing this work. You know what I mean? You know, the work of Yahweh by Yashim Yahweh Shah. Not what some of these wacky tacky Christians believe is the work. That's the real true work. You know what I mean? And like I said, I feel privileged that the Most High opened my eyes to the truth. I mean, yeah, he never said it was going to be always sweet, but we do have a reward coming. You know what I mean? And the Most High is a man and he shall not lie. You know what I mean? So at the end of the day, you know, because he could have just left me blind to all this. You know what I mean? I'm going to stop for a second. Continue. It says, America is to become the base for spreading biblical revival around the world. Like I said, that's spiritual because that's the truth. Because that's what we are, as the men of Great Millstone, are actually, you know, doing. Occupying to the Most High, Yahweh Shah. The Most High's beloved son, Yahweh Shah, our, you know, our Lord and Savior, returns, you know. It says, America must have a president who truly desires to use his power to allow these things to happen. And the only president in our lives who is poised to do that is Trump. Damn, they co-riding and dick riding is Duke Trump. In recent decades, no other Republican make you wonder, did they, he paid him to write this shit? Like, he just, like, against, you know what I mean? Like, hey, nothing. In recent decades, no other Republican or Democratic president. And the crazy part is, I read the chapter before I called myself bringing up the lesson. So, you know, I don't remember reading any of this. In recent decades, no other Republican or Democratic president has been willing to confirm Salaki, confront the globalist elite's plans to create a global super state. Well, you can't stop it, though. Like, at the end of the day, it said in scripture that, you know, the Most High is going to allow him to, you know, set up his enterprise to a certain extent. He's going to crash it or stop it, but at the same time, you know, certain things must come to pass. It is our sincere prayer that Trump recognizes not only the great blessings that flow from obedience to God, but also the potential chastisement or curse that follows disobedience. It is the responsibility of every true believer in Christ to continually lift Trump up in prayer along with his family, administration, and ask the Lord to supernaturally. You're going to skip that. It says a subtitle, A Voice Speaking to Me Like a Trumpet. Christine Lagarde's occult remarks represent the secretive beliefs of the wealthiest and most powerful people in the world. And if you recall, like I said, this was the lady that, like, I guess, worked for the IMF or, you know, Federal Reserve or something. She basically said that she was giving a speech and it was a coded message. She went into numerology. Secret beliefs of the wealthiest and most powerful people in the world. Many are not the secular humanists or atheists they pretend to be publicly. The elite at the top of the Illuminati pyramid are worshippers of Lucifer and Mystery Babylon. Lagarde's announcement of a global economic reset was a kind of coded message to the world's financial elite that they are planning a monumental change in the global economic system. The timing of her remarks reveals much about the nature of the reset. It means the world is moving rapidly toward a global superstate and a cashless society, which you can clearly see. Shit, like I say, just to get your income tax now, they want to put it on a card. You know, majority of things, like, and then to show you how really demonic this system is, everything that you swipe or they want to put everything on these fucking cards, but then everything that you swipe, they want to take a fee off of. Everybody want to get their cut still. It's a way just to get taxed though, for real. Cause like I said, you didn't have to pay everybody for everything with a cash. But now, just to get your money or get access to your money, you gotta pay. So like I said, I mean, like, the job I work at, I don't have a bank account. I ain't had a bank account in years. I was thinking about starting one. I may do though, but I'm trying to actually get away from this job. Long story short, though, so they got this payroll card, and the company that actually issued the card, they
I mean, it's some bullshit because, like I said, you can't really check your balance. I'm basically deducting what I spend and whatnot because if you go to the bank, you're getting charged from the ATM and you're getting a charge for the place that entered the card. You know what I'm saying? But you can't see how much the app doesn't work. It's just like some bullshit. You like, if you call in and try and check the balance, you're getting charged. But you when you go on the app to try and use, like I've been trying to actually download, you know, I downloaded the app, but I've been trying to use the card to open up so I can check my balance. It won't work. So, you know what I mean? Like, it's full of shit. You know what I mean? But it's a fee for every fucking thing. Yahweh Shai warned us in Revelation that the Luciferian control system of Mystery Babylon would arise again in the end times. In Revelation 4, the Apostle John saw a door standing open in heaven and a voice speaking to me like a trumpet. Come up here and I will show you what must take place after this. So who was that speaking to him? Let's go to it then. Revelations 4. Behold, a door was opened in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was as if it were of a trumpet talking with me, which said, come up hither, and I will show thee things which must be hereafter. And immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne. Now, I think that was one of the angels, because, you know, Most High had angels dealing with John, the Revelator. Because remember, because when he showed him Babylon, he was in awe. And the angel was like, why are you in awe? You know, the angel got offended, just like when he tried to worship the angel. And the angel said, don't worship me. You know what I mean? He was like, I am of the fellow brethren. You go. It says, come up here and I will show you that much. Come up here and I will show you what must take place after this. John was supernaturally taken to a dimension outside of space and time known as the spiritual world or a visible realm. Yahweh revealed to him in chapter 17 and 18 the future rise of geopolitical and economic Babylon, also known as the Great Harlot. Now, if he know all this, well, it's two authors in that. Then what did he show him, though? Because he couldn't even talk about ancient Babylon. And there came out of the seven angels. A lot of these Edomites, like I said, they study the scriptures because, you know, Esau likes to search out a thing. So I think they're aware of the, you know, a lot of the truth. They just, you know, you got some that's just spiritually misled. You got some that just, you know, I mean, because it's the Most High. It's ultimately up to the Most High. Well, at the end of the day, that's why, like I said, they can't naturally get right. They know the law, statutes, commandments, and then they call themselves taking a covenant in their mouth, but they naturally gonna just buck up against it. Even the Israelites did that to a certain extent. I'm gonna stop right here.